Let's continue with LeChatelier's principle applied to some different reactions. I have another reaction scenario for you. You'll get to do this in Chem 102 lab for lab 8. It involves starting with a cobalt solution that is pink in color and shifting the equilibrium so that sometimes the solution is blue. Now, normally, water, which is the solvent, is not part of the equilibrium expression. But in this case, water is involved in the formation of our cobalt 2+ complex. So for this scenario, changing or having an effect on water will cause an equilibrium shift. I'd like to show you some videos regarding adding HCl and water and the effect on temperature. So I trust you see that adding HCl shifts the pink reaction to a blue color. And adding water shifts the reaction back to a pink color. Where the Bunsen burner flame is, the solution is starting to turn blue. Now let's take a look at what happened with the equilibrium. Our first question is, what color will the reaction be when HCl is added? Well, you saw that. It turned blue. But why? Two things are happening. First, by adding HCl, we're adding chloride. When you add product, you shift the reaction to the left. Also, adding HCl will start to take some of the water out of the reaction mixture by protonating it and turning it to hydronium. So we have a dual effect. We're adding product and we're removing some reactant. So our reaction shifts to the left and a blue color is formed. We make the blue cobalt chloride complex. What color will the reaction be when water is added? Well, here we're adding reactant, so we will cause this reaction to shift to the right. So we're adding water when it is involved in the reaction, not just as a solvent, but actually part of the complex. So we shift the reaction right, and the solution turns pink. I did not have a video of this one, but I'd like you to predict what color will the reaction be when acetone is added. Acetone hydrogen bonds with water. So this would be like removing reactant. Which way does removing reactant shift the reaction? Well, I hope you believe that removing reactant shifts the reaction to the left. So our solution should turn blue. What color will the reaction be when silver nitrate is added? Silver nitrate interacts by taking away the chloride, by turning it into a silver chloride solid. This is a scenario where we are removing product. And hopefully you remember that when you remove product, we will be shifting the reaction to the right. So it will turn pink in color. Here is one more example scenario to help you understand LeChatelier's, and then your questions will be upcoming. I have here some barium sulfate that I have placed in water and gotten some barium 2 plus ions and sulfate 2 minus ions to dissolve. Our scenario is that we are at equilibrium, so there will be solid barium sulfate in the bottom of the glass and some barium 2 plus ions and sulfate 2 minus ions floating in the aqueous solution. Barium sulfate is that delicious stuff you get to drink if they want to do a digestive x-ray. This turns out to be an endothermic reaction. That means delta H is positive, which means our energy belongs on the reactant side of this reaction. When you stir barium sulfate into water, the solution will actually get cold. Our equilibrium expression is barium ion multiplied by sulfate ion. So we'd like to know, what happens to barium 2 plus when we add potassium sulfate? We're interested in the fate of the barium, and when we add potassium sulfate, that means we are putting more material on the product side of the reaction. If you increase product, which way do you shift? I hope you believe the reaction shifts to the left. So whenever a reaction shifts to the left, what happens to the product concentrations? They go down. So barium ion concentration will decrease. What happens to the barium ion concentration if we add more barium sulfate? So we are adding more reactant. But that reactant is in the solid state. So that's honestly just like adding more solid. Would that increase the concentration of barium and sulfate in solution? Well, think about this. Suppose you are making yourself a glass of sweet tea, and you put 3 scoops of sugar in the glass and mix it on up, and then you let the sugar settle on the bottom. And you taste the top of the glass with your sweet tea and say, "Ugh, that's not as sweet as I would like it." So you add 2 more scoops of sugar, stir it all up, and then let the sugar settle to the bottom. More sugar settles to the bottom because you've added 5 scoops of sugar now. When you taste your sweet tea at the top of the glass, did you get any more sugar into solution? I hope you say no. The solution was saturated in sugar, and adding more doesn't help. It just adds to the solid layer at the bottom. So your answer is the barium ion concentration is unchanged. It was at saturation before we added more solid, and it's still at saturation after. Suppose we add heat. Heat is on the reactant side. So we're adding more reactant. Which way will this make the reaction shift? I hope you believe the reaction will shift to the right. And when that happens, barium ion increases because shifting to the right increases product. What if we add water? Do you see water as a specific component of a complex in this reaction? It's a solvent. So let's say we add a bunch of water and stir up our mixture, and when we're finished, some barium sulfate forms on the bottom of our glass. Will we have changed the concentration of barium and sulfate ion in the water? Well, no. Now, I won't argue with you that more will dissolve. Certainly, if we add more water, the layer of barium sulfate on the bottom is going to decrease because more will go into solution, but the actual concentration will not be changing. We were at maximum concentration before the water was added, and we're still at maximum concentration after the water was added. This brings me back to the sweet tea example. You have your glass of sweet tea with your 5 tablespoons of sugar in it. And you hand it to your friend and you say, "Does this seem sweet enough to you?" And they taste it and say, "Oh, that's far too much sugar." So they bring the glass over to the sink and they put some more water in it. And they stir it on up and then they let it settle. And the layer of sugar settles on the bottom. It's not as thick as the layer of sugar that was there before, but there's still a layer of sugar there. Will your friend have succeeded in making the sweet tea less sweet? No, it's still at maximum sugar solubility. They will have succeeded in giving it less tea taste, but as far as less sugar goes, no. So adding water as a solvent does not change the barium ion concentration so long as we still have solid in the bottom of the glass. Here are your student questions. We are going to focus on the concentration of chloride, which is on the product side. And our first scenario is that we are adding NH3. Which way will the equilibrium shift and what will happen to the chloride concentration? For this next question, we are again focusing on the chloride concentration. This time, we are adding additional silver amine complex. Think about which way the reaction will shift and what will happen to the chloride ion concentration. Again, thinking of the chloride concentration, what will happen when we remove some silver chloride? Not all of it. There will still be some solid available in the container, but we're going to remove some of it. What will happen to the chloride ion concentration? For this one, we would like to add heat. We're going to heat this reaction, and I have told you that delta H is negative. So think about what side of the equilibrium would you put your heat energy on, and what would increasing that do to the equilibrium? For this last one, we're going to add catalyst. For this one, remember that the equilibrium distribution is actually determined by the relative energies of the reactant and the product. Adding a catalyst is going to adjust the energy required to reach the transition state. So if one is already at equilibrium and changes the energy of the transition state, will that affect the chloride ion concentration? It's a silly idea to add catalyst after you're at equilibrium. That's sort of like locking the barn door after the horses are gone. This concludes our questions on LeChatelier's principle. I hope you realize now that you can push a reaction around.